Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to the Bangles. We are going to react to the song A Hazy Shade of Winter. And it's a request of our patron Barry. It's been a long time that we have reacted to the Bangles. It was only one reaction I guess we did of the Bangles. And this is the next one. After that I heard that song many times. It plays at home. And I'm wishing that this song is equally good. A Hazy Shade of Winter.
I've heard this song in my high school and college days.
Okay.
I've heard it a few times, but it's been a while, so I'm looking forward to it. But it's no way a first time reaction for me to this song.
Okay.
Let's see how it goes. But this will be probably the first time I'm actually going to pay attention to the lyrics. So perhaps I'll discuss that if we have the time. Otherwise, Kirti is purely Kirti's reaction. Let's get started.
This was awesome. Musically, it was great. Vocally, it was great. Lyrically, too, it was great. I like it. I like the lyric writing of this. You know, talking about the normal things around during the season of winter. Almost describing the beautiful things, little things around, which everybody knows notices but doesn't care to talk about. And I like the way it was sung. Very well sung. And very well arranged or composed song, with the drums being leading and the guitar playing like a playful instrument from one ear to the other. It was there like a special effect or a special sound. I liked it. Bangles do know their music actually. I don't know why we don't react to more of Bangles, more of the Bangles. But this music is good.
Anymore. They must have
how many songs?
Very short. I haven't really heard much of them, you know. I mean, if they were around for a long time, I probably would have heard more of them. But I think I just heard two, three songs. Maybe three, because we've reacted to two and then this one.
Yeah.
I've already heard, and those two I'd heard. One of them at least, Walk Like an Egyptian.
Even the Mandan Monday.
Manic Monday. Manic, yeah, Monday. Manic Monday. Yeah, we reacted to that. Yeah.
Manic Monday.
Months ago. Yeah, so I don't know. I don't think they had a long catalog, a lengthy catalog. I think it was very brief, possibly just one or two albums.
But the songs are memorable.
Yeah.
Whether you talk about Manic Monday, whether you talk about Walk Like an Egyptian, the effects that they give, something about it that will stick to you for a long time. Now you're the guitar playing like that and the vocals going like that.
Them singing together is so beautiful. They sung together, maybe two, three singers together.
They're three men.
And you literally feel like it's one singer singing, because it's done so beautifully.
Yeah.
So you don't even realize that there are two, three singers singing the whole song. You know, the whole song is sung by two, three singers together.
There are only three of them, right? Three members, not three sure, female
not sure.
members.
Four or five maybe, not sure.
Okay, okay.
We've never seen them.
I've seen the Manic Monday. I saw a video. I only saw three of them, I think, in the video.
Okay.
I remember.
Anyway, what's your take on the lyrics?
I like this.
You don't have much time, so let's get right down to it. Anything you'd like to say about the lyrics?
It's about the hazy winter time, you know, time, what has become of me. Maybe things are not going so well, but she's saying, it's okay. Just shake it off and move on. Something good will happen. Don't worry about what has not gone well. Just move on, something will come out of it. It may look like a hazy winter or something like that, but move past it and it will be again beautiful. Whatever may have gone, may have just gone.
It's also about living in the moment, you know, appreciating the beauty around you, being happy with what you have, making the most of the time that you have today, instead of brooding about the past days and mistakes. Think about today, and instead of worrying about the future, or planning, making long-drawn plans for the future, focus on today. Today, the weather is, you know, right now the first signs of snow. It's now spring also. Later on in the song, it turned to spring.
Yeah.
Once again, back to winter, possibly the next year. So look around, enjoy the weather, enjoy the scenery, enjoy life, enjoy everything that you have, instead of, you know, possibly worrying about how time has gone by and it's getting too late to fulfill your dreams and desires.
A lot of problems.
Yeah, so don't worry about all that. Focus on the now, enjoy the now. That's what I gathered from it.
Yeah.
There may be more to it than what I gathered. Beautiful music. For me, the highlight is the way they sung it together in this song, as well as the guitar riff. You know, the guitar work was incredible. You just remember it. I've heard it a few times in the past, but today listening to it, I knew that about the song for sure. I remember the tune.
The guitar,
before
yeah.
we started.
You
because
know.
It's very memorable, very catchy. So I love the guitar work. I love the drums. There were two kinds of drums played. One seemed to be like the electronic drums and one the usual drum kit.
Hmm.
So both of them were playing together towards the end. It was beautiful.
Yeah,
and then the voices.
The cymbal-like sound was different.
They were incredibly talented.
Like Bangles, they were.
I don't know what's happened to them, whether they're still even alive, I'm not sure. Because it's like, this must have been early 1980s. So what, 40 years passed by. So 40 plus or less, assuming they were all 20. 60, yeah, possibly they should be all still alive. But definitely, I don't think they're making music. Mm. Unless I'm sadly mistaken. Bangles.
This song passes by so quickly. The song starts and you're getting into it and it gets over. It was that kind of a song. It was so breezy, so fast that it came and it went. Like a whack and it's out of there. I want to listen to it one more time to get the complete picture here. To enjoy it completely. But the way the vocals were done, it reminded me a little bit of Queen.
Yeah, Queen, yeah. I also thought about Heart.
Heart, different.
You know, similar kind of music and similar kind of vocals are incredible of Bangles too. Though Anne Wilson is, definitely,
she pulls it on.
She has a wider range and she definitely sounds better. Bangles are incredibly good as well. Talented. I think they're all female though.
Yeah,
not like
yeah,
Heart.
Yeah, yeah.
So full female band they were. And Yeah, including the drama and also.
As far as I know, they are all female band and should be only three, I think.
They were pretty popular. They were pretty popular. People would mention them a lot in the late 80s and 90s. I don't know what happened to them.
They
must have been something that went wrong or something that happened, maybe an illness with one of the members. Something went wrong for sure along the way, which may have ended their career much before time, or maybe they just separated like so many bands do.
Yeah.
You know, so, but I don't think they've had much of a catalog. Don't think. There have been bands who've been around for just 4 or 5 years, but in those 4 or 5 years,
they make a lot of music.
100 songs.
Yeah.
So, but with Heart, I mean, with Bangles, the Bangles, I think maybe they have 20 songs.
That's all. That's too little.
Yeah, 20. I don't think there's more than that. We could check though later.
Yeah.
But for now, let's end this reaction and move to the next one on our list.
Thank you for watching. Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Johnny Rivers. We are going to react to the song Poor Side of Town. We recently reacted to Johnny Rivers for their song Summer Rain. Summer Rain. It's just 4 days ago or something. And we have another request by another patron. Our patron Barry has requested this time for Poor Side of Town.
I think Johnny Rivers is a solo artist, not a band.
Not a band?
Yeah, I think because the name sounds that way, Johnny Rivers.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think it's a band, it's a solo artist with his musicians.
Okay.
Could be wrong though. If I'm wrong, please correct me in the comments.
Yes.
Johnny Rivers, Poor Side of Town. Yeah. Open and honest reactions to this song and the others coming your way. Hope you enjoy that. A personal as well as sincere take on the music that we listen to on Enoma. Let's get started.
Tell me how much you missed me when the last time I saw you, you wouldn't even kiss me. That rich guy you've been seeing must have put you down. So welcome back, baby, to the poor side of town. To him, you were nothing but a little plaything.
Was a plaything,
not much more than an overnight fling.
Overnight fling, you are.
To me, you were the greatest thing this boy had ever found. And girl, it's hard to find nice things on the poor side of town. I can't blame you for trying. I'm trying to make it too. I've got one little hang up, baby, I just can't make it without you. Stay now.
Will I stay now? Do I?
Will you stand by me, girl, all the way now?
All the way now, do I?
With you by my side, they can't keep us down. Together we can make it, baby, from the poor side of town.
And say you need me now.
together we can make it, baby, from the post side of town.
Great music, most probably from the 50s or the 60s. It had a lot of music playing in the background. There were times when it sounded like someone whistling, or there was flute also playing in the music. I like the guitar tune and the drums on this side and the entire rest of the orchestra on the other side. I like the vocals as well, and female vocalists to support or in the backup singers. I like that. The role of the backup singers, or the one singer, maybe the female singer, was pretty prominent towards the end. And the way the song started with do do re da or something, the same way it ended. And in the middle, the entire story that unfolds of the poor side of town.
Beautiful music. I love the flute added into it. It was kind of loud, but it was beautiful to listen to the flute and you know, the golden era song that we just heard. Beautiful, beautiful. It sounded good. The very nice story of a poor girl going to the rich side of town with a guy, and unfortunately didn't treat her right and it didn't work out. She came back to the poor side of town to her old guy, and He realized what she had done, and he didn't blame her. Yeah. He said, you know, even I'm trying to make it. I know you tried hard, even I'm trying. Let's try together, you know, let's get together. If we join forces as a team, we'll surely make it. We'll surely have a better life ahead.
Yeah.
Let's work hard, and you know, because without you, I can't really do much. So I need you and I want you. And he says it very well. So yeah, they are three sides to the story. One is the rich guy's side, a little bit of it. He kind of used her, you know, treated her just like a plaything, didn't really give her that much importance or appreciate what he had with her. He didn't really care about it. She going there thinking that maybe her life will get better being with this guy, and he'll treat her right and she will live like a queen or princess. Didn't quite work out that way. And the third guy who loved her and, you know, was sad to see her go, and now she's come back and he's telling her, you know, yeah, I know that you went there and you expected things to work out and you wanted a better life. I understand that. Let's get together and do it together. So nice song. Beautiful voice once again. Liked the voice of the last time. Today it sounded even better.
It sounded
beautiful
better.
Music and nice, relaxing feel to it, with a valuable message or two, you know, value what you have.
Yeah.
You know, it's important to value what you have. Even if you don't have much, value what you have in life. So, very powerful message I got out of the song.
Hold and on I to always what you have.
It. Yeah, hold on to what you have.
Very active
and value
song.
It. Value it too.
Yeah.
It's not just about holding on, it's about valuing it and spending quality time with loved ones.
Mm.
You know, we always say we do things for loved ones. Whether it's the food choices we make, our diet in the home, or the work that we do. We say we do it to earn money for a better life for our kids or for our loved ones, for ourselves. But at the end of the day, if that's the case, shouldn't we be spending more time right now with them? Isn't that what's most important, to spend quality time with your loved ones? Is it all about money and greed and a better life in the future, which hasn't yet arrived and may never arrive? Who knows, the way things are going in the world today, who knows whether any of us will be around even a few days, weeks from now. You know, it's a realistic way to look at it. I won't even say pessimistic. It's realistic. So at the same time, it helps me appreciate what I have right now by thinking that way. appreciate it even more, value it even more. You know, and I love songs like that because it gives you different sides of the situation. That's how the world is. You know, one side a person may love you, the other side the person is using you in the name of love.
Yeah.
So there's two sides to every story, three sides to every story. And that's presented so beautifully in this song. So I enjoyed it. What are your final thoughts?
Yeah, from the time it is, the song is from those days, it used to be major gap between the classes. There used to be a class system or a status that people used to have. There was the rich class and there was the poor class. Very clear cut. A division was there. Nowadays we have the middle class and in that upper and lower, and then poor and then the rich. So the steps have increased. The division is little bit lesser than those days, and people even in the middle class, upper middle class, can afford a lot of things that rich people have. For an example, smartphones, whether a rich person or a poor person can have similar brand or same brand phones. Those days it wasn't that way. It was the rich people had something that the poor people would never ever get it in their hands. It would be only a dream or a desire. It probably is from those times. Even the movies used to be revolving around those things, that a girl or a guy from the poor class would end up falling in love with somebody rich, and only to know that the rich person was just using or just having a fun time with that person, and at the end they would go with their own kind of people and dump these people like that. And his sentiments with his own people, where she is from his own poor side of the town, and he's saying, you are very lucky that I am, you found somebody who's good in the poor side of the town. Stand by me, stick around, and we will both be not put down by the rich people. We'll both together can make, we can have a good
today
thing.
In today's world, statistically, at least in the West, in America mainly, there is mainly the poor and the rich.
Again?
You know, there's not much of a middle class statistically. So, you know, there, and even back then, I'm sure it was only in certain places where there was a, you know, poor and rich. Today, it's poor and rich. In fact, it's often called in America as the 99% versus the
1%.
So it's that bad, you know, in that country. Maybe in the rest of the world it's a little different. In India we have a vast middle class, and more and more people from the poor and the rich classes are coming into the middle class. So it's a little bit different in India, but in America it's definitely poor and rich class. 99%. In fact, the top 1,000 richest people in America have more than 85% or 90% of the wealth of the remaining country, American population. So it's that bad there. It's not good because the middle class is
the
buying class.
The distribution is not good, yeah.
The lower middle class, the middle class and the upper middle class are the market.
They are the ones who spend,
who buy, and keeps the economy growing. So if that is missing, it's wrong. But anyway, it's slightly off topic, but also at the same time relevant to this song. Hope you enjoyed it. Goodbye.
Thank you for watching. Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma, and welcome to our first time single take honest reaction to Billy Don't Be a Hero. It's a song by Bo Donaldson and the Heywoods. This is the first time that we are going to listen to Bo Donaldson and the Heywoods, and this song, Billy, Don't Be a Hero. It's a request of our patron, Barry. Let's listen to the song and see what it is about.
If you've caught up on the earlier two reactions in this video, just to inform you, if you'd like to know a bit more about us, you can check out our Patreon page. The link is in the description box of the video below. Let's get started. We deliver open and honest reactions. Usually first time listens like today, this song is the first time we both are listening to it in our lives.
Yeah.
And this artist too, or band. So let's get started.
I saw Billy.
Enjoyable song, but ends on a very sad note. I like the music going low at that time, reflecting the sentiment of his fiance. And then after that, I couldn't really enjoy the music, even though it came back in its full force. But the story was sad. The story ended sadly, and it fails to uplift you up after that. Oh, Billy, don't be a hero. I like the music of the song. It was actually the marching drums that were played here. I like the whistle, or was it the flute that made the sound of the whistle. It was very well done, enjoyable music, like the drums, like the guitar playing, everything about the song, even the bass guitar. And I like the most is the vocals, the way it was sung. You know, very easygoing way of singing, but at the same time telling the story to impact enough on the listener. It was very clear, crystal clear way of presenting the story. No two ways about it, no confusion. It was as it is, very straightforward, but sung beautifully with all the emotions at the same time. Brilliant music. Both Donaldson and the Heywoods.
Yeah, very sensible songwriting, beautiful music to back it up. And it didn't sober down. What I would have liked is that if it had sobered down.
Yeah, after, at the end, like it happened.
After he passed away, it still went on with the same upbeat note in the music. So that I found that a little bit strange.
Me too.
It's a great song nevertheless. Beautifully sung, beautifully written, and wonderful music to back it up.
Yeah.
Almost throughout. Obviously, it's a story that connects with a lot of people who have fought in the wars and have lost family members, friends, loved ones on the front lines, you know, or during the course of the war.
Yeah.
So millions obviously have succumbed, millions and millions of people have succumbed due to war and the aftermath of war as well. Whatever has happened after that hasn't been always good for everybody. So, you know, it is sad, and this is one story of Billy, who was very eager to be a hero on the battlefield, serve his country, serve on the front lines, protect his nation, and he wanted to be a hero. He didn't want to stay back and be like the other, any boy or any kid who was just there at home and not serving the country while everybody who he knew possibly was joining the army. Yeah. So he was queuing up. He didn't want to stop himself. He wanted to be a hero. Meanwhile, his girlfriend is telling him that, you know, don't be a hero. Don't do this. You know, but he didn't listen. He went ahead and joined, and unfortunately, he was one of the millions of people who died. She got a letter or a telegram. Usually a telegram would be sent in those days, unless it's a more recent war they're talking about. It's sad. You know, many families have been destroyed and ruined. Their happiness and their life forever has changed because of a death of a son or a husband or a father. It's sad. At the same time, I value what I have because of these songs like that and stories like that. I value what I have because I have not been, you know, belong to a country where there has been a lot of war or bloodshed on the battlefield. I've not seen that side of life, at least after me being born. I've never seen it anyway. I'm blessed, and I believe I never take my blessings lightly, because, you know, I do know a lot of people have not had the same fortune. So I have not had to serve my country, or at least on the front lines. I never had to do that, and I hope I'd never have to, because war, as our country has proven, is not the answer. You can win your independence without lifting a sword or a gun. So I believe I'm blessed. That's my side of the story. If I want to give an honest opinion, I believe I'm blessed. But I do know it's unfortunate that Billies exist all over the world, and they have perished, they have died, they have succumbed on the battlefield due to a war which perhaps not everyone wanted to fight in the first place, you know. So yeah, that's my take on it. What are your final thoughts on this, Kirti?
I don't know when things will change, when scenarios will change, when the common sense that is not so common, definitely not common in the world, will actually prevail, and people will start understanding the damage that the wars have done so far on humankind and on this planet, and will continue to do it if we don't stop it. If we really don't stop the weapon and weaponization of this planet, we are only and only going to perish. It's not just one Billy, but there have been millions and millions of Billies. Within a few years or so, maybe the number will turn into a billion as well. With the rate it is going, the system and the governments and the people involved, they don't want to reveal the right numbers. It may have already passed.
Yeah. It's not just about war. In this case, it's about war. So we are
all kinds of weapon use and use of such force, which is not natural. And the sooner we realize, the better it is, the greener we can make this planet.
Yeah, one statistic that really shocked me recently, since my dad died of brain cancer. One statistic that shocked me very recently in a very recent documentary on health, you know, I don't know the name, but it was coming on one of these channels, Discovery, or one of those lifestyle channels. So the statistic is very recent, of 2018. It says that 1 out of 4 Americans dies of cancer.
Wow.
I don't know if that is actually true, but if that many Americans die of cancer, I'm assuming even in many other countries, the incidence of cancer must be pretty high.
Yeah.
So it's quite sad, you know. So that and the documentary, it's sad because it can be prevented. At least some kinds of cancers can be prevented.
Yeah.
Like skin cancer, lung cancer.
Yeah.
And few other cancers can be prevented by lifestyle changes, diet changes.
Even colon cancer.
As well as having regular medical checkups. It's as simple as that at times. That a regular medical checkup can save the day and your life. You know, so yeah, so... it's sad. So maybe Billy is not dying on the battlefield today, but it's certainly
dying of cancer. A lot of Billys are dying of all the other
and high blood pressure and stress related diseases and problems. That's it for this one though. Goodbye.